Okay, now it's time for a windshield shot. This is part of Route 332, Newfoundland. There's a little loop marked on the map off Route 330. No mention, though, of the crushed stone and mud surface. So, just another little adventure to today's side trip up to the North Shore, north of Gander. Back on the paved road again in some of the area near Davidsville. This little coastal community. One benefit I'll say of that gravel stretch there is there wasn't much traffic. And you could see hoof prints on the side of the road, so they didn't need to put signs that said moose around here. You could just look for where all the hoof prints were. I'm not sure how the camera's going to capture this, but this is sunset at Deer Lake, Newfoundland, where I've shut down for today. Tomorrow it's forecast of rain again. I'm going to do a little bit of urban touring around western Newfoundland before the return on Saturday. So 5 minutes out of Cornerbrook, heading southbound on the Trans-Canada. This is in the Humber River Valley. The river's just behind the trees in the foreground. Some very, very beautiful scenery here in between some of the, I guess this is the extreme north end of the Appalachian Mountains, so and upward a little bit there. It's hard to get the impression of height on video, okay, we're not talking Rocky Mountain height here. We're talking maybe a little higher than you get in most of Maritime Canada or New England. Foggy distance, you see the next mountain, and about 5 minutes around the corner from that hill is the local ski resort. There aren't many cities or towns anywhere in Canada or states that have a major ski resort that's like maybe a 6 minute drive from their city center. It's quite impressive. As I say, it's hard to compare with the western mountains, but the only place in Ontario that might compare a little bit to this is the rock cuts coming down toward Nipigon, north of Lake Superior. And again, it's kind of a misty morning. I know the people that write the reviews on breathtaking views must always come on sunny days, which I'm guessing would be no easy task in this part of the world. And so on to Cornerbrook. I'm going to do a little bit of makeup footage here. This is the Railway Museum in Cornerbrook. They've kept locomotive 593. And they preserved a few of the original railway passenger cars that went with it. The Newfoundland was a narrow gauge railroad. There are no more railroads in Newfoundland, so this truly is a museum exhibit. I did this once before, so I won't belabor it, but just for those of you who may have missed that footage, this is preserved by the Railway Society of Newfoundland. Apparently, passenger service ended in 69, freight service ended in 88. There's a few other railway cars they preserved, a caboose, diesel, and right at the very front of that line up an orange snowplower. Apparently they built narrow gauge with a view to cheaper construction and the ability to make tighter turns in difficult terrain. But in the end it proved to be simply a compatibility issue with the mainland railways that helped to make the running of railways in Newfoundland not feasible. And as you can see, they preserved one of their last diesel engines. would guess that in this climate, the snowplow had a pretty good workout as well. Corner itself is a town that lends itself to videoing. To the right is the mouth of the Humber River, leading into the Humber Arm, which is an inlet coming in off the Gulf of St. Lawrence. Sort of suburban shopping centers down just below us to the right here. And the large body of water that's coming into view on the left of the screen now is the Humber Arm, which is the harbor, if you will, serving Corner Brook. The white smoke is the pulp and paper mill. This is a pulp town. That's how it was established. And then as I pan into town itself, you can see the road running around the edge of the harbor up to the right. And essentially downtown is the at the bottom of the hill in front of us. And the residential area you can see sort of spread out, all those little white boxes up the hill. They say all the great cities of the world have some sort of relief to them, the hills of Rome and Mount Royal in Montreal and what have you. Corner Brook is a kind of interesting place to tool around because of that. I've just done a quick circuit of downtown and it's, you know, you get lost at every corner type of thing because every street comes in at a new angle. And coming into view of the hill to my left is the I guess the southern suburbs of the town. You get a much nicer view of Port-au-Basque off these new ships. They're a lot taller. This is the Blue Puttees, the sister ship of the Highlander, which I came over on. She's going to be very full today because the Highlander apparently had mechanical problems yesterday and last night's sailing was cancelled, so we're looking at two loads in one here. About the end of about the fifth line loaded, and there's still quite a lot of vehicles out there on the tarmac waiting to board. About an hour and a half out of Nova Scotia. Another uneventful crossing. You know, whales and dolphins being such intelligent animals, I have to think they don't know these new ships yet. The caribou and the smallwood ran this route for like decades. They must have known it was safe to swim alongside, and what course the vessels would take, and so on. I think they really just don't know these ships. as you can see, we're full. It's been a good solid hour and a half. I'm presuming the vehicle deck below is full too, but no reason it wouldn't be. They were loading both together. One advantage of this open style ship, of course, is you can watch for whales off both the starboard side at the same time. Don't have any annoying Volvos with car alarms that are on deck this time. I'll take advantage of this brief orgasm of sunlight that we're getting as we approach North Sydney. Off the port quarter here are the small communities that are on the outskirts of the city of Sydney. And I will pan around. To the North Sydney side. And the approach to the terminal. As we arrive in North Sydney, the Leif Erikson is sailing. If the other big ferry has mechanical problems, I imagine the Erikson's going to be busy for a while they catch up with the commercial traffic. Shediac, New Brunswick. Nice little touristy, welcoming information place they have here. And the reason for this diversion off the Trans-Canada Highway is that a couple of people I work with in Toronto want me to bring back some lobsters, so this is supposedly the lobster capital. Even though the guy at the info desk doesn't know the current market price, I guess I'm about to find out. Later. And besides, it's a nice day, and I got in an Adler gift shop before the tour bus arrived, so things are going well so far.